love again. I keep falling down, I keep on hitting the ground. I always get a nasty what's next. Birds don't just fly, they fall down and get up. Nobody learns without getting it wrong. I won't give up, no, I won't give in till I reach the end, and then I'll start again. No, I won't leave, I wanna try everything, I wanna try even though I could fail. I won't give up, no, I won't give in till I reach the end, and then I'll start again. No, I won't leave, I wanna try everything, I wanna try even though I could fail. Look how far you've come. You fill your heart with love. Maybe you've got enough. Take a deep breath. Don't get yourself up. Don't need to run so fast. Sometimes we come right, but we did our best. I won't give up. No, I won't give in till I reach the end, and then I'll start again. No, I won't leave. I wanna try everything. I wanna try even though I could fail. I won't give up. No, I won't give in till I reach the end, and I'll start again. No, I won't leave. I wanna try everything. I wanna try even though I could fail. I'll keep on making those new mistakes. I'll keep on making them every day. Those new mistakes. Try everything. Try everything. Try everything.
All right. That sort of pumps me up. Wow. Hey, everybody. Okay, we're good. Hopefully the connection is working out well. Let me figure out the camera here. I was going to cut that song up earlier, but that song is my jam. So we played the whole thing. How's everyone doing? It's Tuesday, right? What is? Yes, Tuesday. Today is actually my brother's birthday. I don't know if he's on. He's probably celebrating his birthday. Mark Woodside, if you want, you can say happy birthday to Mark. Yeah, I'm excited for today. We're going to be learning how to draw Judy Hopps. She's from the film Zootopia, or Zootropolis, depending on where in the world you're from. And she's a fun character to draw. She's pretty simple, but there's some fun little nuances that we can learn along the way in her design. So yeah, we'll start with the usuals. If you guys have done this before, this is the boring part for you. You can hear me say the same thing again and again. But if you're new, I wanted to say who this class is for. This class is for people who are learning how to draw. This class is for people who know how to draw and are just trying to have a good time to distract. It's a weird time out there, right? Where we're all inside for a bit. So this is a good way to spend an hour. We're gonna have fun. We're gonna listen to some good music. And we're going to learn how to draw a character. So a couple of things that I'll be using today. I'll be drawing with my underdrawing today will be in purple. You can't see color from this distance. Purple. And then after that, we'll go over in the normal darker pencil. A couple things for people who are I've gotten some messages from people who are like, I like watching, but I'm not going to draw. I don't want to draw. Just draw it. What do you have to lose? We're going to have fun. I'm teaching you simple shapes. It's circles. It's letters of the alphabet. You can do it. I promise you can do it. There's a lot of people who posted up yesterday that they were so excited that they finished their drawing and they were thinking about giving up on it. So I think we have a good group of drawers who are interested in just having fun together. So one of my main things for this program is that we're all isolated in our homes, but just because we're separated doesn't mean we have to be alone. So right now already there's like 150 people in this thing, and it'll grow and then more people watch it later. So we're all together in this, and let's just have fun drawing a character together. So I'm going to move your camera back. Get ready. Ooh. I'm sure there's a better system for this, but I don't know it. Okay, so you'll see right off the bat, my paper is turned differently than normal. Because she's a bunny, she's got those big ears. I want to make sure that I have space in the paper for her ears. So I'm going to turn the paper sideways. Let's get our music back. The awkward part where you hear me breathe until we figure that part out. Cool. Okay, so we got Judy Hopps. We're going to take that off so we can actually draw. So she is a fun character. I got to animate a lot for her on the film Zootopia, so I feel connected to her. Oh, if we're focusing. Let's do this again. Focus on that. Hello, my hand. Yeah, we bring it back here. There we go. Okay. So if you haven't done this before, what we do is we draw circles on the side of the page, and then we will warm up. So these circles are just sloppy little circles that don't need to be anything special. We're just sort of getting our arm warmed up to do what we need to do for the drawing. So Judy has a lot of really nice round shapes with some surprise corners that we're going to make sure that we hit. So just do a lot of little circles over here on the side, and they kind of overlap. I'm trying to keep them off to the side because we're going to do our drawing in the middle of the page, and I want to make sure we have room for that. I definitely need to warm up today. I like this purple. So some people were asking what the pencils were that we were using. I have the blue one I was using yesterday was just a Prismacolor. How close can we focus? That's too close. It's just a blue Prismacolor, which is a standard brand. And then this is a purple color race. So I really don't have, I'm not like a loyalist with a type of pencil. I'm sort of a pencil, I suffer from pencil attention deficit disorder. So I just bounce from tool to tool and whatever inspires me. And if I do a bad drawing, I usually blame it on the pencil. So I don't know if you're like me. Okay, so there's some familiar shapes in this. If you drew Stitch with us before, there's some overlap of design, so you are a little ahead. So let's go ahead and start with Judy. We're going to put her head sort of towards the lower part of the... Oh my goodness, you're right. Look what I did. I forgot already. Again, hand sanitizer. They've been in the box forever. I'm touching them. We got to make sure we clean our hands right now. If you're new, you're like, what is happening? And if you're old, you're like, why did he forget? Okay, we're cleaning our hands because this is art time, and these supplies might be, you know, a little dirty. So we're gonna make sure that we clean up. We're gonna clean up right afterwards. Okay. Oh, now I need to warm up again. Now my hands are slippery. Okay, do that again. Thank you for the reminder. Okay, so we're going to put the head a little towards the bottom of the page, and I'm going to start with a circle, but I'm going to do it really lightly because we're going to actually add onto the circle to make her head more specifically Judy. I'm going to check the camera, make sure that's not too light. Okay, so the Stitch part, we're going to go straight to it. Remember the gumdrop shape? Gumdrop, little candy that's bigger on the bottom, kind of squished and then rounded on top. And then we built Stitch off of that, right? So we're going to do a similar kind of shape for Judy, where we're just going to take it from the top of the circle, bring it out a little bit, kind of round it back. And then same on the other side. I want to give it the gumdrop bottom here. So this is the shape that we want to base her head off of. And And then for this pose, we're going to have Judy looking this direction. There we go. She's going to be kind of looking, oh my goodness. There we go. Sorry, trying to do this angle backwards. So she's going to look here and then a little bit down. So that is the plan that we're going for. Remember, we just drew these lines in here just to show the directionality of the head, because everything that we're doing is a dimensional object. We're just trying to replicate on paper. So let's go ahead and do those lines. We're going to put them right here. And I do everything really lightly because when I go back later with a darker pencil, then I can define the areas that I want to keep. Here, just practice on this. So if I do this, then that helps tell the audience the lines that I intend for them to see. And the scratchiness is actually kind of nice. It has a animatory quality to it. So I'm just sort of arbitrarily making choices about which ones to outline. Do a little shading, just wasting time as you guys catch up. There we go. That's real. That's art. Okay, so here we are with her face. And I'm going to just go ahead and start doing the nose. So the nose, I'm going to do a little, kind of an oval. A little bigger than that. I do it lightly because at the bottom of the oval, it kind of comes to a point. So it should look almost like a guitar pick. If you've ever played guitar, it's kind of a shape that feels like that. And this is a pretty common shape for Judy's design language. And design language is basically a set of shapes that help define the character that are consistent. So Mickey's design language is circles. Her design language is this kind of wedge shape, kind of. Cool. I'm just going to darken up a little bit this top part of the line. And we're not going to darken this area over here, just here. I'm going to give her a little nose bump there. One of the best things I've heard from people who've taken the class before is that they feel like even without knowing how to draw or ever drawing before, or maybe being told that they didn't know how to draw in the past, they still feel like they can get somewhere fun with it. So I've seen so many people say that they started a drawing and hated it, and then by the end they were super happy with it and couldn't believe they did it. So that's huge. I love that. So let's just go ahead and finish off the nose. It's going to be a simple little line that goes from this corner over to this side, little guitar pick lines. Just sharpen that up a little bit. Some time to catch up. I kind of want to finish with the shape of the head real quick. So I'm going to give her the cheeks. And so the cheeks are kind of interesting. They're a little tricky. So I'll do a little sample cheek down here. If this is the head shape that we did, we want to make sure that Judy is a really bright, optimistic, happy character. So we want to make sure that her cheeks show that she's smiling. And so we put the peak of this line out here. So it points upward. If we did it this way, then she might look like she has saggy cheeks or she's sad. So even how the cheek moves tells us how she feels. So I'm going to kind of build roughly how that works up here. Maybe a little too quirky. Then we're going to add a little bit of the cheek over here. It doesn't need to be as much as this side. And it just connects to the bottom here. Okay, now I want to give you a second to catch up. Pull this up so you can see it. Since we have the nose started, I just want to start building the rest of the muzzle. So if you look at this shape here, this kind of bottom quadrant here, you go about halfway over to the middle and then more towards the top, put a little line there like that. So about half the distance from the center to this left side, and then near the top, put a little line there. And that'll be the corner of the mouth. That's the part over here that we always see. We did for Stitch. So for the actual muzzle part, I have a cool thing that I can show you all here. We have a maquette of Judy. Let's see if we can get it to focus. Focusing. There we go. So we're going to just start drawing this part here. And that is pretty close. You see it's pretty close to the nose. And then there's a lot of room down here below the mouth. So we want to just do this part, that line. So that line, we're looking at it from this angle. Pretty similar to what we have so far. So let me get the lighter on. Here we go. So you'll see that this line appears a little longer than this line because it's foreshortened. It's going away in space. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to do a long line here and then a short line back around there. So fit Judy back up safely. There you go. So I'm just going to go almost to the where the circle is here. And stop there. And from where we stopped it, I want to be pretty close to the mouth here. I'm going to do a little line that feels like this, like a little, see that? Yeah. So it's not a straight line. It's a little more rounded. So I wanted to start that here. Because they're a little cute. No, we can't call her cute. That's offensive. She doesn't like that. It's the appropriate shape. And then this other side, remember, it's shorter. So we're just going to go right back up to where the circle is. Kind of finish it up there. And if you want, you can actually just connect this line here. A little rounded detail. Someone asked me how I retrace my lines so precisely. The trick is you have a low resolution camera and you put it far away from your drawing. Because if you saw what I saw, it's pretty scratchy over here. Okay, so let's give her big teeth. So her teeth shape, if we were looking at it from the front, it would look like this, right? If this is her mouth, it would go like that. But since we're looking at it from the side, this kind of rotates around. So I'm going to practice it over here. It kind of goes like that. So it's just very slightly slanted from what we have here. And since this tooth on the left side is closer to us, it's a little bigger. That's why we put the center line here, because it's closer. I'm just going to draw that in. Give me a second to catch up. All right, next we're going to move on to one of my favorite parts is once we do the open mouth, then that will really give her some really nice expression. So it's pretty simple. If you want to, we'll be starting up here and then we're going to end up over here. And for that, we're just going to go down and make a soft V. See, if you want, you can bring that all the way down to the bottom of the gumdrop shape. Soft V. And by soft, in case you're wondering, this is a hard V, right? It has that corner there. And a soft V is sort of like a U, but I think it's a U, I feel like, is more like that. So soft V just takes these lines and then kind of rounds them out a little bit. So U is different than V. That's the lesson for today. Okay, we're going to draw this tongue, and then I'm going to show you a cool thing. So the tongue is another, pretty similar to the tongues that we've drawn before. It's an M shape, but since it's from the side, just like this tooth, the first part of the M is going to be bigger, and then the second part smaller. So now we can see how the tongue goes back into the throat. So here's a cool thing. At the end of the film, everyone who worked on it got these really nice pamphlets. They're like a little brochure. And inside the brochure is this awesome spread of Zootopia. And then inside that is all of the credits. So they printed out all of the credits for the film and put them on this. So some really nice shots down here at the bottom. And the animators are start at the bottom here. See how close we can focus. Nope. And then it goes all the way up to the top. This right showed up. Yeah, so this is a really nice gift. They didn't have to do that. So there's the production babies. If you look for production babies, that means a baby that was born during the film. So you can see kind of how long we worked on it by how many babies were. One of the interesting things about Zootopia is that in the beginning, for a while, Nick Wilde was the main character of the film. And then as the directors were developing it, they realized that Judy Hopps had a lot of fun opportunities to explore. So they considered making the movie more about her. And then Jennifer Goodwin's voice came in as the voice of Hopps. And then she sort of took it away and kind of stole the show. So then the movie became about her journey. Yeah, so she's got a lot of fun, spunky energy. She wants to make the world a better place, and I think we can all get behind that. Okay, so now that we're here, let's go ahead into the eyes. She has really big eyes, so that's why we left a lot of space up here at the top of the head. So I'm going to start on this side. If you think of the eyes, they're kind of like this shape a little bit. If you think of like a pumpkin seed, oh, that's too close to where the ears will be. Pumpkin seed sort of is like maybe an almond shape, but it's just stretched out a little bit. There's just these little points here, and I'll show you where they go. So here, just on the right side of the nose, but not all the way over, we're gonna go straight up and then arc around towards the side of the circle. And then here, we're gonna bring it towards the middle line, all the way out to the side, really big eyes. We're back to it. I'm not gonna stop it. I'll turn it down a little bit so it doesn't. Okay. And then we're gonna do the other eye. So that's gonna be when I'm thinking about where I start the other eye, I'm imagining the same line. It's dimensional. So starting from here, I'm thinking all the way around. So I'm gonna start it probably about right here. Then I'm going to end it about right here, I think. No, we'll go here. So I'm making the arc go down to the bottom of the original center line. It's a weird shape, so don't feel weird if you have to do it a couple times. Shakira just said the perfect thing. Nobody learns without getting it wrong, so we gotta get it wrong. Okay, and we're gonna go here and sort of arc it all the way back around. Maybe a little too small. Yeah, for those of you that don't draw and say you don't draw, why don't you try everything? Okay, so normally when we outline the character's eyes, whenever we make it a little darker up top, we're going to do it a little differently for her because she has these great eyelashes that are out to the side. So we're actually going to outline starting from the side and then around here. Okay. And then from that area, we're going to just draw the eyelashes. So I like doing the eyelashes as just sort of one big block. So I'm following this line, the path of the circle, sort of a tangent from there. And then meeting it over here. So eventually we're going to color that in. I'll lightly do it here. We're going to color that in with a darker pencil. And we're going to do the same thing on the other side. So we're outlining the outside. So I just I put this one up pretty high, the peak up here, and I wanted to mimic that over here, so I brought that one up. So I was making adjustments, thinking about how I can make them feel similar. Cool, so let's give her eyebrows now. So the eyebrows are really thin, and they go right up above. There's always this little break here. This is an important design detail that we always make sure we put in. And then over to the right. Up, over to the right. And then for the eyebrows, if we went two up, she went like sad and confused. So just almost horizontal across here, but with a little arc on top will give you the brightness. I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. Smaller because it's the farther away eyebrow. Added some new music to the list today from Zootopia. I love Michael Giacchino's music, and it's a cool score with a lot of different instrumentation from around the world. Okay, let's go ahead and we're going to give her the little tufts of hair on top. It's similar to all the other characters. Remember, we have these for Stitch. Hers are a little more scratchy, so we're just going to go quick little lines. I don't do too many of them, so it's not too detailed. I don't want to draw too much attention to it. And before we do the eyes, I'm going to go ahead and start doing the ears. I was talking with Kira Latamaki, and she is the animation supervisor for Hopps. She's awesome. She's a great animator. I'm sure you've all seen her work, and you love it, even if you don't know her by name. And she was talking about the design of Judy's ears, like spoons. And what does that mean? So if you see a spoon, it's not really flat. It's kind of rolled forward. So you see how it comes up. Where we go? Where is the profile? Here we go. So it comes up and then rolls forward and then comes back around. So that's sort of what Judy's ears do. This is the side here. So we're going to try to mimic that with our drawing, and I'll show you how we can achieve something like that, I hope. Otherwise, it'll be hilarious for all of us. Okay, so she has really big ears, so that's why we left a lot of room up top. And I always like starting from the circle, the very bottom of the gumdrop, and kind of lightly just going wild with the big lines. Big lines. So the way that I feel like I can get the spoon scoop, is have one side that's more rounded than the other side that comes in a little more straight. See how this feels more straight than this side? And then round it up top. So that's the first part of the shape. And then we can do the other ear, which is similar. I think if we make them both point up in the same direction, we can do that. But sometimes it's more interesting to have one go off in a different direction so they don't feel the same. Sometimes when designs are parallel, it doesn't give that much interest. But if you were to take that same design and kind of turn one the other way, then it feels more like there's some weight there. And that's what we're doing with the hair here. That's what we'll do with the cheek hairs when we do those. So I'm going to do the next ear, the same principles, rounded and then a little more flat on one side. So I'm going to start here, rounded. And then bring it back in, and then a little more flat. So that gives us the outline of her ears. Okay, so to get the cupped thing, when we drew Stitch's ears, remember this was his ear. We did the S curve from there, and then it felt like it opened up here. And so this part of the ear, the back of the ear, kind of got hidden. For Judy, we can see it all the way up to the top. So I'm going to start following this line, like a big S. I'll change it a little bit. There we go. See that weird S shape? And that gives her some thickness on her ears up here, the fluffy ears. Do the same thing on the side. S shape. Okay, so at this point, I can hear you all saying, I hate mine, I'm gonna throw it away. Don't do it. Don't do it. We're almost done. You're gonna like it. As soon as we put the eyes in, you're gonna like it a lot, I promise. I'm gonna bring this in a little bit. I'm gonna do a little too. Oh, fine. Okay, so let's go ahead and put the eyes. We're gonna have Judy looking right at us. So it's gonna mean the eyes are gonna be a little different from each other. We're gonna start with this one. It's a little simpler. We're gonna draw just a circle right on the middle of the eye, looking right at us. I bet your circle looks good. Some of you think like, okay. Starting to look like her. I see it. And if you have more room on your page, you can go really big with the ears if you want. Kind of right out of room. And then the other eye, since it's looking right at us, if you think of this as like a rounded sphere, looking right at us in the middle of the sphere would probably be about here. So we're going to actually do the same trick we've been doing where we draw the circle kind of squashed on the far eye. So this is more of an oval. And then I have left a little room here. We talked about that, the negative space to keep the eyes from looking too crossed. I'll show you what it looked like if I did that differently. So if this is this eye here, a little darker. And then that was the other eye and I went too far with it, it wouldn't look balanced. So what I did is I just pulled this eye a little bit to the right. And then that looks a little more like she's looking right at us. So let's go ahead and add a highlight right in the middle and then towards the top. And I want to draw another little circle inside for the pupil. I like this purple. Okay, so let's go ahead. We're going to do a quick collar. So her collar, just going to see the top of it. I don't have enough room for the whole body. So we're just going to draw this weird shape. It's a weird shape, isn't it? But if you think about the collar that's being pressed out by the neck and head, that's what that is. So it would normally be up like this. Barely see that? It would normally be up like this. But since she's pressing on it, it kind of pushes over this way. So it's that idea. And we'll do the same thing on the other side, but it's a little smaller, right? Because it's farther away. And then it's simple to get just the shoulders. We can kind of do a little S curve down here. And then from this side, we're going to do a bump. Because that's, she's proudly standing and facing this direction. So I'm going to draw where the collar ends. If we were to see the collar from the front, it would be, where's a good place to do this? I'm running out of doodle space. If we were to see the collar from the front, it would be like this and then rounded in the front. But since she's facing this direction, the lowest part of the rounded area is going to be a little farther to the right for perspective. So it's similar to this thing. So if we were drawing it straight on, it would be like that. But since we're drawing it to the side, the point is over this side. So we're going to do that here. And then I'm just going to draw a little line for her shoulder. She just kind of comes off this guy here. Cool. So we have some time still. Let's go ahead and darken some of these lines. And then while we darken too, I'll start showing you where the cheek lines go. You know, let's go ahead. We'll do it in purple just to make sure that everyone is tracking with it. So there's little cheek firsts that happen here, and they're just going to be light little lines that come off to the side. Nothing too complicated. And I think that'll be better defined with our black pencil. But in the meantime, so let's go ahead again. I'm right-handed. I'm going to start on the left side. You can start wherever you like. So I've talked about it before, but I like pushing away from my arm while I'm doing the arced lines. So I'm turning my paper around to do that. Keep this straight. And as I'm drawing these big lines like that, if you want to watch this one, I've used my whole arm. I'm not just trying to do it with my hand. I'm going to push my whole arm out there. It gives me a little more control. And the control that you guys have or don't have is just from experience, or you're still working on experience. So keep doing this and then you'll get better and better. You guys remember my Donald drawings from yesterday when I was a child. So always looking to get better. Everybody's drawings looked more like Donald than mine did from yesterday. So well done. So when I am outlining, I'm going to leave the area outside of the eye purple or with my underdrawing, and then I'm going to start picking it up again in front of the ear. So the ear, both ears are behind the head. If we were to see Judy from the side, she's kind of like this, and then the ears are back here. So this is her nose. Not a great drawing, but the ears are back behind her head. So we want to make sure that we have this cranium line in front of that. Cranium. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and do an eyebrow. So don't forget to, if you post up your drawing online, use Drawing with Woodsy as your hashtag so that I can see the drawing. Also tag me in it. People have been posting to Instagram or Twitter. It's a great way for me to see it. I'm gonna color in this eyelash. Like this. Got lucky, we pulled up a lot of Zootopia music today. I'm gonna do the mouth corner. So I know a lot of you out there, because you're probably like me, are perfectionists, right? Where you expect every line perfect and every drawing to be perfect.
That is never going to be the case. There's always going to be something you want to improve on it, which is why it's important to finish a thing, because you can learn from it and then move on to the next thing. Sometimes I think we can hold on to our own projects for too long and then never actually finish anything. So a finished thing is valuable. So be sure to finish your drawings so we can share them with somebody. So when we were working on Zootopia, they were actually renovating their main animation building, and we were working in a building that was sort of a warehouse where they would build rides for Disneyland. And there was a hallway in the back where they had a bunch of treasure that they were storing from Pirates of the Caribbean, which was wild. Just walking around one day and seeing a bunch of treasure and maps. So we were there for a while. It was on a street called Tahunga. It was actually a joke in the film where Mr. Manches lives on Vine and Tahunga. And she mispronounces it to Junja, Tahunja, something like that. So that was a crazy place. We were all the animators were in the same room. Basically, there were a few pods where people would be off to the side, but for the most part, everyone would be in the same room. My favorite would be someone would send around an email. It was a funny email or it had a joke. And one of the animators at Disney has the best laugh. His name is Darren Butters. He, as soon as he got the email, you'd hear him. Can't do his laugh, but it was great. And so you knew like something good was coming. Darren animated the shot that everyone loves of the sloth getting the joke. A really slow laugh. And that's something he actually pitched. As an animator, sometimes you have an opportunity to say, hey, I had an idea for something that could help plus the jokes that are already there. And Darren is one of the funniest people I know. And so he just kept adding time and time and time and time to it until the shot became what it was and ended up being like the breakout shot of the film. I love that one. Cool, so let's go ahead and go to the eyes. I'm gonna color in this eye darkly and then lightly do this one. Probably gonna come back with my purple and do that again. It's tricky because I just did the left eye first, which means now I'm my hand on everything. So to cover that, sometimes I will just put a piece of paper down between my hand and the drawing, and then that way I'm not smudging anything. I keep the paper still. I got a shine on it. It's weird. There we go. That's better. Yeah, Judy is tricky, so this is a fun one to go back and retry. I'm going to do her mouth a little darker than I did the eyes, but not totally black. She has a badge here. It's kind of a complicated shape, but it's easy enough if you just do a circle. If we were animating her on paper, that's probably what we would draw for the most part on that side. It's a little oval that is kind of coming away from us. So you see, as I'm coloring this part in, this is her vest, I'm coloring that in a little darker, kind of the medium tone. And I'm trying to keep everything moving in the same direction so that I don't get too much crossing. Slowly adapting the direction as I go, so that it follows what I imagine is the form of her vest as it comes down. So it's coming down this way and this way, this way, this way, around that way. So my lines kind of fan out like that. So that's another way to do the trick that we've been talking about where you draw the colors in the same direction. But this way you can do it following the forms. You should be thinking about everything as a three-dimensional object. I'll sharpen my pencil. So another area that we didn't really indicate that would be colored in is the top of the ears. Her ears have this pretty dark tip. So I'm just going to start coloring that in kind of loosely because she's furry, so it doesn't need to be too perfect. Making little circles like this to color that in. Kind of scribbly, but feels sketchy and feels fluffy. I'll do the same on the other side. Hope the internet has been better this time around. I know yesterday we had some technical difficulties, but feels like it's working a little better today. So Judy is a gray bunny, which means it's very easy to color her in because we're just going to use our regular pencil. And I'm going to use the side of the pencil so I get this kind of texture and not like this. So like this, that way, that's why I just sharpened it so I can get a better line. So I'm just going to start with the ears. She's got a little area around her mouth that we're not going to color in. So I'm just going to stop coloring about there, right when I get to the mouth corner, underneath the mouth. And then start coloring in over it, but leave the muzzle. And start coloring in the nose. Just go ahead and do the other side so that we all know what part we're gonna leave white. Thinking about the forms, kind of rounding them out a little bit. And then we're gonna do the top of the head. Since I have a red here from before, I'm just going to start, just do the tongue a little bit. I also kind of want to color the nose with pink. So if I just color it lightly with red, or if you have a pink, you can use that too. But it's a little pinkish. Oh, I forgot the other ear.
What?
As animators, you should always be thinking about form and dimensionality. We mentioned yesterday that not a lot of animators need to shade their work because the job is to do a lot of drawings and a lot of work. So you don't want to do extra work that you don't need to do because eventually a cleanup artist is going to come through and make your work shine. Let's do some shading. So you don't want to do too much. So you don't have to because you have a lot of work to do. And while we have the red, might as well do a little bit inside the ear. She has these kind of pinkish ears, so I'm going to go really lightly, just forget who is an animator who just called it kissing the paper. It's gross. Sorry, you shouldn't have to hear that from me. Same on the other side. I'm getting carried away, guys, but I'm here. I'm going to color in her shirt blue. This is, say, if you're coloring her in, then you can do the whole thing. Of course, you don't have to. If you want to continue working on outlining, that's totally cool. Following the forms, the path that I'm using, and kind of finishing them off down here. And then the other sleeve. And because I'm a completionist, she has a gold badge. So let's find goldish. This is yellow. That is Judy Hopps. Said it might be nice to try to put a little purple in the eyes. I'm going to do that. It's mixing in with the gray from earlier, so that looks pretty cool. Slightly darker on the pupils just to separate it. I don't know when to stop. I could go all day long. Okay, can you see it? We can see. Cool. That is Judy Hopps. Now, if you haven't done it yet, be sure to sign your drawing with your name. I'm going to put my name right here. These eyeballs are going to be looking right at it. Cool. Let's put the camera back. Actually, make sure to do one last look at it. Get this light out of here. There we go. Okay. That is our Judy Hopps. So be sure to share that drawing with somebody. You can give it to your mom. You can give it to dad. You can give it to your brother. You can give it to your sister. You can give it to anybody. You can give it to grandma. So if there's requests that you guys have, you can leave them in the comments for here or in the comments on Instagram. That is usually where I will end up looking for them. I love being able to do this with you guys. It's so much fun. I hope you have fun doing it. Drawing shouldn't be stressful. It should be a good time. Peaceful and relaxing, and we need that right now. So don't forget, just because we're separated doesn't mean we need to be alone. And I'm thankful that you guys are here with me today. So we'll see you tomorrow, same time. I have a good idea for who we're going to do. It's going to be fun. Bye now.